Hello friends, welcome to Reachgoals. Today I'm going to talk about content delivery network, or otherwise called as CDN, right? In this we are going to discuss about CDN system design and some of the sample interview questions. And the most interesting interview question is how to explain the content delivery network to a layman. So let's understand what CDN is. So basically, instead of having all your content in the origin server, you can have the content in your closest location, which is called as an edge server. So that means if a customer coming and accessing your content, they don't want to go to the origin server often, and instead they can get the content from the closest location, which is called as an edge server. So there are a lot of benefits to that, right? The first benefit I see here is the speed, right? So since your content is not at the origin server, always you're not getting your content from the origin server and you're getting from the edge server, which is closest, obviously you're going to have the speed improvement in your system because of the low latency and because of the data which is traveling with the low network, right? The second thing is scalability, right? So if you have hundreds and thousands of customer and if they all want to get the content from the origin server is going to get high traffic and it's going to get loaded very fast, right? Instead, if you have all your content in the closest location and the traffic to your content or the traffic to your content at the origin service is gradually reduced, in that way you can scale your system across multiple users or thousands and thousands of users, right? The third one I have is origin high uptime. What does it mean is if the traffic is not going to hit very much on your origin server, there is a high possibility your origin server is going to be up for 99% of time, right? So in that way, you can keep your origin server too at a high level, right? The fourth I have is a security or DDoS resistance. So what I mean here is, if you have all the content put into your origin server and if a traffic is coming and hitting over your origin server quite often, there is a high possibility of security risk, right? So you can have a DDoS attack on your origin server and it can be tossed, right? So instead, if you have all your content in the edge server and the traffic getting into the origin server is reduced, there is a less possibility or less security risk over here. In other ways, what we can do is, in the edge server, we can implement a lot of security policies and make sure you can filter the security concerns over there, right? In that way, you can implement the security features in the edge server as well, right? So the other interesting interview question here is how to explain the content delivery network to a layman, right? So if you see in the screen, I have put the pictures like there is a farm which is in the California where I call it as an origin server, right? Which are producing the fruits and vegetables. And the left side of the screen, you see the customers who are shopping from New York as well as from the Texas, right? If a buyer or the customer wants to buy some fruits or vegetables, they don't want to go to the origin server location, which is in California, right? Instead, they go to the nearest stores or vegetable stores to buy the products, right? That is how the content delivery network also works, right? So they don't want to go to the origin server if they want to get a web page. Instead, they go to the edge server to get the web pages, right? So what really helps them is it reduces the traveling time from the New York to California. Similarly, if you look into the real application, what it does is it reduces the traveling time from the New York customer to the origin server customer, right? The second thing is scalability, right? If everybody enters to the origin server, which is a farm, it's not going to withstand or it's not going to suffice all those customers, right? Instead, all the content is distributed across different stores and they can go there directly and they can purchase or pick up whatever products they want, right? So that is how I'm trying to correlate the real CDN network with the distribution center of farms and the vegetable stores, right? So in this, let's try to understand how the CDN works, right? So let's say if a customer is in San Francisco accessing a web page like walmart.com, right? And the content is or the web application is deployed in the origin server, which is at the New York, right? So if they don't have the CDN network, what actually happens is they have to access the content directly from San Francisco location to the New York location, which is really far and it is going to take a lot of time and the latency is high. So now if I have a CDN network, let's see how it works, right? So there will be a CDN location somewhere and you will have a lot of edge servers, right? So what happens here is the content comes and sits in the edge server, and the user don't want to go into the origin server. Instead, they can go to the edge server through the CDN and get the content very quickly, right? And the edge server will have the content, either way it can be directly pushed from the origin server, or the edge server will be have the will have the capability to get the content from the origin server. And this is one edge server. See, think of the companies like Akamai or Amazon. They have content servers, sorry, they have the edge servers across the globe, and wherever you're accessing, they have the closest location and they can get the content very easily, right? So they will have n number of edge servers across the globe, right? So the benefit out of that is, let's say if you look into the red line, if you want to access from the San Francisco to the origin server, typically it might take 400 milliseconds to get the content. Let's say if you have an edge server which is closest to you, it might take 100 milliseconds. So that's how the CDN works, right? Now let's talk about CDN system design, right? If you look into the companies like Amazon or Akamai, they have their own CDN network and they are done with their proprietary algorithms, and it is not disclosed, right? I'm trying to build a system, CDN system with the existing infrastructure, right? And this is a very common interview question asked at multiple companies like Amazon or Facebook, right? So in this design, what I'm trying to do is I'm going to build a origin server, which is in the New York location where you are going to deploy your WAR files or the JavaScript files or whatever files, which is in the origin server, which is in a New York, right? The second step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the edge server, which is very close to your customer locations like Los Angeles or some other location which is very close to that, like Texas, right? Then the next step is I will go and install the web servers in the all the edge servers, right? So basically the web servers can be Nginx or the Tomcat, and it has to act like a cache server, right? Or it's kind of a reverse proxy. So it should have an ability to cache the content and it should store in the edge servers, right? So I can build the edge servers in multiple locations like Arizona, Texas, Florida, right? And you can keep on building that across the globe based on your need and the customer's availability, right? The next one is I'm going to Amazon Route 53 and I'm going to configure my DNS. In that, I can point to multiple edge servers and say that, you know, I can also configure the policy in such a way, right? The URL, whenever it comes from the customer, it has to figure out the closest location and deliver the content. That is my next step, right? Once you do that, that's it, right? So when your customer is hitting the traffic from the San Francisco, it goes to the Route 53 and it determines the closest location. So the closest location for San Francisco is Los Angeles, right? So it tries to get the content from the Los Angeles and it serves the San Francisco customers. You should also notice something like, you know, there is a blue line which connects from Los Angeles to origin server. What it does is there is a web server which has been already installed in the edge server. It tries to get the latest content from the origin server and it keeps over here. So in that way, you always have the fresh content, right? So there are multiple algorithms to implement in such a way to get the content or the fresh content from the origin server, and you can place it into your different edge servers which are very close to the customer locations, right? So here, if you see all the steps, whatever I talked in this slide are clearly mentioned. If you want, you can read it and understand that, right? Now let's talk about some of the production issues which are very common in the CDN network. The first one is delay in the content to the customer. Let's say if you want to display a content exactly on specific time, like, you know, for example, Black Friday, right? So all the customers wants to see the refreshed content at 12 midnight because it is a Black Friday and there are a lot of deals and sales going on, right? So now if you publish the content to the origin server, it is not going to reflect across the globe at the same time. It is going to take some little bit of time. So you have to plan in such a way the content are displayed a little bit advanced so that the contents which are published in the origin server gets pushed into the different edge server based on your need, right? Second thing is about the caching issue. Let's say you have hundreds and thousands of edge servers deployed across the globe, right? Now, if you don't see any content at one of the server, or if the edge server is having the older content, it is not going to display the fresh content, right? So here it comes as a production issue saying that the cache is having the older content, it is not reflected to the customer, right? So what should you do now? So the only option I have seen is you have to clear the cache at the edge servers, right? So you should be very clear what is the TTL at the edge server and make sure that content is getting cleared appropriately at a certain point of time so that, you know, the fresh content gets reflected. This is a very rare case. If there is some network delay or network issues, this could have happened, right? Otherwise, all the softwares like Akamai or Amazon, whatever they are giving, they have a excellent TTL mechanism where if you are setting a time limit, like, you know, at 12 o'clock, all the content has to be cached, it takes care of it, right? It's a very rare issue which happens, but just I want to tell that, you know, this could be one of a production issue which can occur due to the content delivery networks, right? Thanks for watching.